Form a big circle.
force anything, just let go. You can bend your knees a little bit, try to feel relaxed. You can close your eyes, you can smile to people. one specific characteristic, one specific body part that somebody else in the room has, which we think is most attractive that we can see. We can start from you. Yes. I've chosen a specific word for
one for everybody?
No, one, just one.
Ah, from
for the whole.
One for someone. My friend?
I asked him.
Yes. Mm-hmm. He has a very nice smile.
Okay.
I love your smile. There isn't anything attractive.
Hmm?
There isn't anything attractive.
Yes, a lot. I just don't want to share it.
I think it's okay. I understand what you're saying.
Do you feel that you need to protect something? My own emotional setting?
Me? I said, you? What's your name?
Costadinos,
Flora.
He's here.
He's here. He's very nice here, and he's serious and very sweet. Okay,
so if you could choose one specific characteristic, this would be the hair?
Not only the hair, because it has. He's a serious. But I'm very sweet together, and for this I share him.
I think it's your turn to say who you find attractive.
I visited many people. I saw information about this. Just join.
Okay.
Where do you come from?
Mm-hmm. Taiwan. Near China.
Yes. Nice smile.
Yeah. do you have child? Or have you married?
Yes.
Yes. But I am divorced. I have a son.
I have to coach queer friends who have chosen the same fashion. I like to be scared.
I say your hair.
Both eyes, both persons' eyes, both Petrus and
Lina.
Lina's eyes. They cover everything.
I would say his eyes too.
Okay, now you all went around. It was your smile.
Thank you.
See, it wasn't that difficult.
No, but I was like, I don't know your name. You just got it.
We know your name.
Yeah, and yours. What's your name?
Clara.
You said it.
And yours?
El Kioni.
You?
Yeah. Yes. Hello. My name is Mark. I come from Taiwan, Taipei. Nice to meet you, everybody.
This is your smile?
Yeah, naturally.
Δεν είμαι προετοιμασμένος για αυτό καθόλου.
Καθίσου, λέω.
Α, τα αυτιά μου. Οκ. Έκανα μπάνιο, έβαλα μπατονέτες, ελπίζω να...
You can see yourself.
Α, οκ.
Τι χατιστέρεις.
Do you think your shoulders are attractive?
How should I answer this one?
I don't know, because someone told that. She thinks your shoulders are attractive.
Do you think your shoulders are attractive?
I would say nothing special. We're talking about my shoulders, no?
And I wanted to know how it feels to get asked something like that. Do you think of single body parts of yourself? Think about?
That it's attractive, that I consider it as an attractive one?
Not necessarily about attractive. No, attractiveness, I don't know. Just do you split up your body in single parts? When do you do that?
It depends.
Yeah. Same with the questions, I guess.
Why is this ear attractive?
I mean, are you asking me? No.
No, I'm asking everybody.
Because it's hairy.
Is it hairy?
It's not hairy.
Because it's dirty.
It's not dirty.
Is it dirty?
Drevo me ass.
It's small.
Because
it has a nice shape, but isn't it a bit short?
And then they say that the ears of a man keep grow up, keep growing up till he dies. No.
Ah.
You quiz. It looks like an embryo.
It looks like?
Embryo. Embryo.
Εγώ να πάω σε ρηλά εδώ και ένα χρόνο, 1,5-2. Και είχε βγάλει πάρα πολύ. Είχα πάθει οτίτιδα και δεν μπορώ να κάνω εξίσωση πια στο. I can't. Πώς είναι εξίσωση? When you go deep underwater and you swim and you squeeze, you put your breath out and you squeeze your nose. So the. Yes. So the. Your eyes pop. Your eyes. Your ears pop. I can't do this anymore.
You hear well.
Hmm?
You hear well?
I hear well, yes.
Why are you embarrassed?
I'm embarrassed.
You said so.
Right.
I'm getting over it.
Because I had the phone with a camera in my ears and I think it would be disgusting.
Why?
Because I don't know how clean I am.
Is it disgusting or attractive?
Something between them.
You know, this video with all these details will be archived forever, and I'm wondering, the end of the story, can we control our social image? Is it up to us?
Not always.
What
do you mean by social limit? Social image.
I understand social limit. Also
interesting. To control the social limits that we have,
and the one that we want to create. Yes, I agree. Because we create a public image, but we cannot always control it. We create through social media.
And do you think that it really represents that or represents you?
I'm not talking about me.
I'm talking about us. I think, no, our social image doesn't necessarily represent us. Sometimes it's a persona that we adopt or we want to be or to project, maybe. Sometimes it might be true also.
There is not an I in the we?
A we is many eyes, but also maybe it has its own identity. Maybe. Maybe it's just theory.
Every person has a different we and a different I. I would say. So.
If you Google up your name, won't you find something? Even if you don't have Facebook. Yeah, true.
What is your name?
The other person was my former professor.
Is this your exhibition?
Mm-mm.
Is this your profession?
I don't know.
How is it connected to you?
Interesting question. I never get the internet.
But we don't care about one person.
Hmm?
We don't care about one person only.
Yeah. Why don't you have a site?
Because I don't have the time to.
Yeah, this is why it's all.
Somebody you didn't have time to rebuild it.
Does everyone? Oh no, you don't. But who does have a website? You? No. Do you have a website?
Maybe click here.
Yes. The next. Do you want to see it or I don't know?
Yeah.
Okay. Why?
You want to see the next image?
Yeah, true.
Yes.
This doesn't work there. You have to go up and click on the words after my name. It's a shitty old website.
What
is
words? Yeah. Here it says. Not in fact. The two tags after your name.
But now we have
something
similar. You have a bachelor of arts, basically in communications design photography, with Professor Vicke Lofberg in the University of Applied Science, Boston. And after that, Bachelor of Arts in Media Photography. Ongoing development of photography. some publications.
If you speak reason between you, we don't understand something. But it's okay.
She asked him if he wants to do it again, and he said that he doesn't want to, and then she suggested that we film it and we put it on YouTube, and he said no.
Thank you very much.
Although it's from your end.
You should be focused.
Do you like seeing yourself on the internet?
Depends. I hope there are not naked photos of me later.
Naked photos of what?
Naked.
Is this what you're afraid of?
I'm not afraid of anything that I have done. I'm not regretting anything, so...
So why do you not wish for naked photos of me?
Because maybe they make fun of me at work.
We can't hear.
Hmm?
We can't hear. He said he's afraid that maybe some naked photos of him are online. And he feels bad about it because he has a very short...
Time.
Maybe, yeah. That's what he said.
Can we dance on that? Can we dance?
I guess so.
Can you put it back?
Yes, after he stops coming.
You can also answer.
No. Oh, yeah. I wouldn't mind, but he would mind. Because he's from my job. So, how do I explain to him that he... Do you really want to hear it again?
Hmm?
Do you really want to hear it again?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm the DJ, I don't dance.
That was it?
Yeah, it's a comment. It doesn't do one forever. Do you want to play?
Can we dance imaginary music?
What?
Can we dance imaginary music? Let's try.
Without music? With imaginary music?
With or without imaginary?
We have our heartbeat. It's not.
I don't think that.
Thank you.
Solo, 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 solo.
Okay, just a duo. A duo. Duo.
Duet.
Dance together.
This mother.
Or is there, or might there be a difference in creating a social space and exposing people?
I guess in social space, people expose themselves.
If they do it themselves and freely or with their own choice, sure, but how about exposing others? Is it an act of violence? Depends.
That depends on the pressure that somebody puts on me. For example, if somebody puts a lot of pressure to you to do something that you don't like from the beginning, it's a different thing if you're afraid or if you don't know it. But if you don't like it, you know what you don't like, then yes, that's, I think that's exposure, that's bad exposure for you. Because you feel pressure, and then you can, your reaction will be unpredictable. You could either close back to yourself, or maybe you could become angry and do something bad, I don't know. But you don't expose yourself if you don't feel it inside, that I don't want to show myself at all.
Do you mean as a person who is exhibiting or as a visitor?
Do you think this is valid inside an art space like that?
No.
What's the difference between here and the reality?
I don't think if you hit the floor it's violent. For me, that's
why.
This
is quite violent.
Yeah?
Maybe a broken story rather than.
Ah, okay, violence and destroying something is the same then?
What?
Is violence the same like as destroying something?
Not only, but many times.
I thought about violence like I don't know in English. Hurting a person or a living being, but. Oh, yeah, true.
Can we use violence in order to revolt, make a revolution?
This question is too big for this moment. Cannot answer it without context.
Can we?
Yes, I think we can. Sometimes it's the only way to change things completely.
So if you were Stalin, you would have killed all these people to create, like, to regenerate wealth, to redistribute wealth?
This was the action of one person.
But do you agree with violent revolution or not?
Yes, but this depends. It means many people want to change things. Sometimes one person make violent things or kill people in order to have power. That's different.
You all agree with that?
I don't believe in violence. But it reminds me that the violence there is. And sometimes start something peaceful and finally you must to use violence.
Today I feel like really confused and everything. I think we change the modes sometimes and they created some weirdness to me, at least, and I think to them also. I think we should have talked a little bit, I would like us to have talked a little bit about why we chose this specific characteristic, and for me, I really wonder why I find attractive the things that I do. I mean, I would like to, you know, like study the soldiers of Lina, and see why I find them attractive. What is it that makes me feel that this is an attractive, bold-eyed person inside the show? And yeah, I don't have an answer, and I'd like to talk about it a little bit. Also, yeah, the social image thing that occurred was interesting to me, and the fact that we, on the spot, were able to check how the social image is interpreted by people, it was also interesting.
For me, at least, it seemed like you changed your role. Before, you were one of the persons with the poker face, and this was somehow aggressive to me, that all of you guys who invited us to join or produce the space were the poker face artists. I don't know why, I get it. And now you talk about yourself a little bit and about what you find interesting, and now I'm interested. I would like to know more about.
Weird how when you play, even when you're forced to react in a different way, you feel different from your own body. And I don't know if it was a shared experience today, but every time I do a different character or I speak differently, even if I speak only differently, I change mode and I strain myself, even if I do it like on purpose, you know, like I know. The props didn't became the central thing of the room, certainly, but this broke to violence directly. It was only possible interpretation of the bad is violent. This reminds me why things and objects have agency. And the projector worked like that. The fact that we projected us they are creating this conversation about the body parts or the opposite, something like that.
This part about the appearance of our images and of ourselves on the internet, and about what is exactly embarrassing, what kind of exposure is embarrassing, this comment about the nudity. I found that it was a bit of a paradox because we were exposing a part of someone's body which was a naked part, was not covered by something, and but they did not consider this as nudity. And then it's like what you consider as exposure is the exposure of your body. as if our minds are not exposed every day, as if what we post on the internet or the way we act is not exposing us.
Also that the handy thing happened was announced when we were already in here and the door was closed already and it started before asking or telling that this would happen. So there was actually no agreement in the first place. And then it happened that we stayed and somehow silently agreed.